Hey guys, welcome to round one. Here we are on the play. Hand seems fine. The Children of Corlys is dead. The extra Grizzlebrand is dead. This hand actually can't entomb for Grizzlebrand, so it's more likely that we Cabal Therapy ourselves, which isn't really ideal. Yeah, there's only two Grizzlebrands in the deck. I think we're gonna keep it. If I already had a Goryeo's Vengeance or a Reanimate or something, I would just not even play my land on turn one. I'd go pass the turn, and then turn two, draw my card, pass, and basically slow dredge a Grizzlebrand into the graveyard. The only real difference between doing that on the play or the draw is that your opponent gets one extra draw when you're on the play, as opposed to when you're on the draw. Otherwise, the cost of skipping your land drop is roughly similar. Let's lead with Probe. Opponent has mulled to 5, so that's a good sign. Okay. Looks like we're facing Eldrazi here. Wasteland Factory, Reshaper Endless One. Mimic. Draw Lotus Petal. Oh, that's interesting. Because we could Lotus Petal, crack, cast Ponder, and then shuffle immediately. I think I'm fine waiting, though. I'm just going to Ponder now. Awesome. Yeah, Brainstorm's one of the better cards that we could have hit. Go top, top, top. And there's no real reason to brainstorm now as opposed to next turn right before our fetch. Does he want to waste land? He does. Chalice for 0. Okay. Opponent has correctly put us on combo. I'm going to put both Grizzlebrands back in the deck, I think. No, let's just put one. Let's put Grizzlebrand Children in. And then I think I'm going to fetch a basic island. And I think I'm going to brainstorm at his end of turn. Maybe I should probe now then. The life loss starts to become a factor with Grizzlebrand, but I think we can afford to pay. Well, if we paid 2 more, then we wouldn't be able to Marsh Flats. I could just cast the probe. Yeah, let's just cast it. I think we have time. Yep, we knew all those cards. Shallow Grave, cool. So now we just need to find a discard spell to target ourselves, or we need to find an entomb to get the Grizzlebrand out of our library. So this is a fairly slow draw for Tin Fins, but our opponent has kind of had a slow draw themselves. Yeah, they have no way of interacting with this at the moment. So they get to see our hand, but then it doesn't really help them. Then we're just going to pass the turn back. And if they did somehow mess with our hand, we could hide the Shallow Grave in response. Yeah. It's worth brainstorming? I think so. Okay, we can't entomb reanimate Children of Corlys quite yet, so I'm gonna draw another 7. This should be everything we need. Yeah, we can make an Emrakul off this. No need to loop our deck or find the children or anything. We can just win. Yep. Cool. How much graveyard hate do we think our opponent is going to have? How good is Chalice against us? Do we want this Serenity? Sideboarding with this deck is always pretty difficult. I kind of want to try out the Mentor plan, just against everyone I face, to see if it has any legs. One of the problems I have with the Mentor plan is that we're facing a Wasteland deck, so if we fetch out a Tundra to cast Monastery Mentor, then we could waste it off of it and not be able to play Swords to Plowshares or whatever. I think I'm going to throw a Serenity in here over like a Probe, and I think I'm going to call that good. I'm just going to click Submit here. We could bring in Swords to Plowshares to hit Thought Knot Seer, but that doesn't seem that good to me. Yep. I'll keep this. They basically need some... Okay. I was gonna say turn one disruption. We seem to have found some in the form of that Leyline of the Void. Yeah, so like a turn two Rest in Peace or something like that would not be good enough in the slightest. So we still have a Serenity in the deck somewhere, and that's kind of what we're playing towards. They usually always play like 4 Thorn of Amethyst, but I don't know if I can cold call that when I know that he has some other cards in his deck. So I'm actually just going to name... Oh my god, Moto. Moto Y. I would like to not have to do this. I guess I'm just gonna do Eldrazi Mimic. Double Thought Knot Seer, which is coming down this next turn. Yep. Next game. Okay. Now that we know these got ley lines, I kind of want to try out this sideboard plan even more. The Emrakul out. What else do I need for the deck to still be functional? I actually don't think I like Bobs in this matchup, but Mentor could be really good. I want to shave some number of reanimation spells. We're at 65. Maybe we don't even need tendrils. I kind of like that. Two is so much mana. It's so much mana. It does deal with Leyline, so does Chain of Vapor. for way less mana. And Chain of Vapor is pretty cool with Monastery Mentor. So we just need to figure out four more cards to cut. I think we go back to Shaving a Probe. We could go, like, full with it, like cut like all of the reanimation spells and bring the bobs in, maybe. I like that less, I think. Okay, let's try this. Should be interesting. We're gonna be pretty weak to a chalice for one. Okay. And give his hand a little snip here. His hand looks pretty good too. I do kind of wish this Entomb was a Dark Confident. Could have ritualed it out on turn one, started drawing cards. Yeah, let's set a stop on our upkeep. I think that's okay. Cool. So he's going to Thought Not Seer me on turn two here, and we're going to respond by fetching out a Tundra and Brainstorming to hide the Monastery Mentor. And then on our turn three, depending on what he takes here, I might end up tapping the top on his end of turn or before my draw step. So that I get an additional trigger, like if I get to keep the Dark Ritual. Vomit. Do I want to protect the Dark Ritual? I don't think so. I think he takes the Entomb. I definitely don't want to F6 because, yeah, if he leaves me with the Dark Ritual, then I want to draw with top at his end of turn. Oh, he took the Dark Ritual. It's unfortunate. So we simply draw. I think I want Scrubland so I can't be wasted off of a color. Okay. So he gets to hit me for 8 here. I'll drop down to 6. And then he'll probably play a Matter Reshaper. Probably should have done that pre-combat, huh? Extra point of damage. Yep. Considering spinning top here, I think my plan might just be a little bit too slow. Yeah, it's just gonna be a little bit too slow, unfortunately. If we found like a chain of vapor for the ley line, then we could just combo. There might be a problem with this sideboard plan. So if we just blind draw off top and hit a land, like a Manasaurus, then we replay top, play Entomb, Shallow Grave. Get enough tokens to survive, but not do much better than that. I think I do just want to blind draw. Okay. I kind of want to not run out the top. I kind of just want to therapy away the last matter reshaper in his hand and then entomb on his turn. Which I still don't think is winning, but I think it's my best line. So what's a dead draw here? Random fetch. We could just hit a fetch. So the opponent's draw was pretty strong. He not only had the hate card that he didn't have to mull for, but then also like the exact two lands, and then the rest all gas, which is pretty good. Highly recommend that if you have the option. So let's just mess around here. We're only at 4 life, so I don't think we can afford to do this. Yeah, this would kill us. So I think we're going to be like killing off matter reshapers and doing some chumps. Is it better to go down to 1 and do that? I don't think so. Be really nice to kill a Thought Knot Seer. But it's not in the cards. Yeah, his Thought Knot Seer here was so brutal. Because otherwise we'd be trading with his Eldrazi Mimic, the Thought Knot off the top. So I think we're just going to lose, but we'll give it a draw. Why not? Kind of a fun match. I think I got the impression from playing this game that the matchup is actually pretty good. Games 2 and 3, we were a little bit weak to Leyline specifically. And in game 3 it had to be Leyline plus like a lot of pressure to stop Monastery Mentor. Which he had. So interesting. I look forward to playing this matchup more in the future. Definitely, most definitely. Because it is very popular right now, the Eldrazi deck. But yeah, GG's opponent. On to the next round.